Hello everyone, welcome back to the course, Power Plant Engineering. Earlier, we have started our discussion with the nuclear power plant. Now in this lecture, we will discuss on most important component of nuclear power plant, which is a nuclear reactor. This is the generalized layout of the nuclear power plant, where on the left hand side, you can see a nuclear reactor. In a nuclear reactor, the nuclear energy is going to convert it, or nuclear fuel releases the energy, and that energy is being utilized to convert water into the steam. That steam is going to drive the turbine, which ultimately drive the generator, and we will get the electrical output. The reactor is powered using continuous fission reactions to generate a continuous flow of energy. The kinetic energy produced during the fission reaction is converted into the thermal energy. The fission products undergo extreme declaration, where kinetic energy is converted to heat. A neutron moderator can be used to check the speed in the reactor. The heat produced is transferred to a coolant, which is either used directly or indirectly by converting into steam. This can be used to operate turbines, thereby converting the thermal energy into mechanical energy. And then after this mechanical energy has been converted into electrical energy with the help of synchronous generator. Let's see the main components of nuclear reactor. First, the core. It contains all fuel and generates the heat required for the energy production. Coolant. It passes through the core, absorbing the heat and transferring into the turbines. Turbine, which transfers energy into the mechanical form. The cooling tower. It eliminates the excess heat, is not converted or transferred. And the containment. The enveloping structure that separates the nuclear reactor from the surrounding environment. Let's see the classification of nuclear reactors. Reactors can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. A heterogeneous reactor has a large number of fuel rods with the coolant circulating around them and carrying away the heat released by the nuclear fission. In homogeneous reactor, the fuel and moderator are mixed. For example, fissionable salt of uranium, like uranium sulfate or nitrate, dissolved in the moderator like H2O or D2O. The solution is critical in the core due to difficulties in the component maintenance, induced radioactivity, erosion and corrosion. Homogeneous reactors are not common for the utilization. Present days, nuclear reactors are of the heterogeneous class. These reactors are again classified according to the type of fuel used, the neutron flux spectrum, the coolant and the moderator. So depending on different types of fuels, neutron flux spectrums, coolant and the moderator, the nuclear reactors are classified. Let's see some commercialized nuclear reactors which have been used for the nuclear power plants. First is the boiling water reactor, pressurized water reactor, pressurized heavy water reactor, high temperature gas cooled reactor, and liquid metal fast breeder reactor. Apart from this, we have some reactors for the research purpose. We have some reactors for some military applications. Even for further applications, we have different small types of nuclear reactors. Even for the big ships or submarines, we have the nuclear reactors. So let's see the detailing of these type of reactors. The first is pressurized water reactor. The excellent properties of water as a moderator and coolant make it a natural choice for the power reactors, and pressurized water reactor has been extensively developed in the United States of America. The most important limitation on pressurized water reactor, that is PWR, is the critical temperature of the water, which is 374 degrees Celsius. This is the maximum possible temperature of the coolant in the reactor. And is in practice, it is considerably less, possibly about 300 degrees Celsius to allow a margin of safety. In PWR, the coolant pressure must be greater than the saturation pressure at say 300 degrees Celsius or 85.93 bars to support the boiling. The pressure is maintained at about 155 bars so as to prevent a bulk boiling. The PWR power plant is composed of two loops in series. In the schematic diagram of pressurized water reactor, on the left hand side you can see one cycle and on the right hand side the another cycle. The left hand side cycle is a coolant loop called the primary loop and the water steam or working fluid loop. The coolant picks up heat in the reactor and transfer it to the working fluid in the steam generator. The steam is then used in a Rankine cycle to produce the electricity. The fuel in PWR is slightly enriched uranium in the form of thin rods or pellets. The cladding is either of stainless steel or zircaloy. Because of the high coolant pressure, the steel pressure vessel containing the core must be about 20 to 25 centimeter thick. A typical PWR contains about 200 fuel assemblies, each assembly being an array of rods. In a typical fuel assembly, there are 264 rods and 24 guide tubes for the control rods. Grid spacers maintains a separation between the fuel rods to prevent exclusive vibration and allow them axial thermal expansion. The coolant leaving the reactor enters the steam generator, which can be either shell and tube type with U2 bundles or one through type, the former being more common. In the U-tube steam generator, the hot coolant enters an inlet channel head at the bottom, flows through the U-tubes and reverse direction to an outlet to the bottom. It can produce only saturated steam in the ones through the design. The primary coolant enters at the top, flows downward through the tubes and exit at the bottom to the main pumps. Feed water is on the shell side. A dry or low degree of superheat steam is possible. The first land-based pressurized water reactor for the power generation was built in the United States in 1957. Its thermal output is 231 megawatts. The pressure in the primary circuit is 141 bar and the water temperature at outlet from the reactor is 282 degrees Celsius. Dry saturated steam is generated in the heat exchangers at 41 bars at 252 degrees Celsius for gross electrical output of 68 megawatt. The thermal efficiency is 29.4%. So in the pressurized water reactor, the most important part or most important component is the pressurizer. The coolant in the PWR primary loop is maintained at the pressure about 155 bars greater than the saturation pressure corresponding to the maximum coolant temperature in the reactor to prevent bulk boiling. Because liquids are incomposable, small changes in volume due to changes in the coolant temperature because of either a load variation or sudden nuclear reactivity insertion causes severe or auxiliary pressure changes, due to which pressure may increases or decreases. If the pressure increases, some water will flash into steam and it will affect the reactor performance, often leading to its burnout. If the pressure decreases, there may be a cavitation. Thus, it is necessary to provide a surge chamber that will accommodate the coolant volume changes while maintaining the pressure within permissible limit. Such a chamber is called the pressurizer. Let's move towards the next type of न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर विच इज अ बॉइलिंग वाटर रिएक्टर. अ बॉइलिंग वाटर रिएक्टर और बी डब्ल्यू आर डिफर्स फ्रॉम द पी डब्ल्यू आर दैट इज प्रेशराइज वाटर रिएक्टर इन दैट द स्टीम फ्लोइंग टू द टर्बाइन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड डायरेक्टली इन द रिएक्टर कोर. Steam is separated and dried by mechanical devices located in the upper part of the pressure vessel assembly. The dried steam is sent directly to the high pressure turbine, thus eliminating the need for the steam generator. The schematic diagram of boiling water reactor is as shown in the figure. The coolant thus serves the triple function of coolant, moderator, and working fluid. Since the coolant boils in the reactor itself, its pressure is much less than in a pressurized water reactor and it is maintained at about 70 bars with steam temperature about 285 degrees Celsius. However, an increase in the boiling rate displaces water, that is moderator, in the core and reduces the ability of the moderator to thermalize neutrons and hence reduces the reactor power level. At power level about 60% of the nominal, the fraction of steam in the core can be kept nearly constant by varying the coolant circulation rate. The saturated liquid that separates from the vapor at the top of the reactor in a steam separated flows downward either internally within the reactor or externally outside the reactor and mixes with the return condensate. This recirculating cooling again either flows naturally due to density difference or by forced circulation pump. The ratio of recirculated coolant can be saturated vapor produced is called the circulation ratio. The BWR core exit quality varies from 10 to 14%, so that circulation ratio is of the range 6 to 10. This is necessary to avoid a large void fraction in the core, which would reduce the moderating power of the coolant, resulting in low heat transfer coefficient or vapor blanketing and burnout. Next type of nuclear power reactor is the gas-cooled reactor. The first gas-cooled reactor with CO2 gas at a pressure of 16 bar as a coolant and graphite as a moderator were developed in the Britain during 1959 to 69. The fuel was a natural uranium clad with an alloy of magnesium called Magnox. Several types of gas-cooled reactors have been designed and built by England, developing an advanced gas-cooled reactor, AGR system, and Germany and the USA developing helium-cooled graphite-moderated system, HTGR. The AGR uses UO2 as the fuel clad in the stainless steel tubes with the CO2 gas as a coolant and graphite as a moderator. The graphite moderator helium cooled HTGR is designed using uranium-233 as a fissile material and thorium as a fertile material. Initially, the system would have to fueled with the uranium-235 until sufficient uranium-233 is available for makeup fuel. Because of the very high melting point of graphite, these fuel elements can operate at very high temperature and it is possible to generate steam at conditions equivalent to those in the modern coal-fired power plants. The basic fuel forms are small spheres of the fissile and fertile materials as carbide, UC2 or THC2. The fissile spheres are 0.35 to 0.50 mm in the diameter and fertile spheres are 0.6 to 0.7 mm in the diameter. Each sphere is located with two or three layers of carbon and silicon carbide. to prevent fission products from the escaping from the particles. Helium is a suitable coolant in the sense that it is chemically inert. It has a good heat transfer characteristics and low neutron absorption. Being a monatomic gas, it can be produced more power for a given temperature in the Brayton cycle and higher efficiency. A direct cycle HTGR gas turbine is used in most of the commercial application. It incorporates a regenerator and multi-stage compression with intercooling. Typical figures from such cycle are pressure ratio 4, turbine inlet pressure 50 bars, turbine inlet, that is reactor outlet temperature 900 degrees Celsius, compressor inlet temperature 50 degrees Celsius. The temperature at other points with the uranium-233 or thorium-232 fuel. The HTGR functions as a thermal breeder reactor. So till the point we have discussed about three nuclear power reactors. First is the pressurized water reactor. Second is the boiling water reactor. And third is gas cooled reactor. The further two types for the commercial applications nuclear power reactors we will discuss in the upcoming lectures. Thank you.